Derek Lewis for Mr. July. And again, breaking the mold of, all that, big is beautiful in MMA. But I think one of the most important things that I'm kind of working on at the moment would be, not only my fight inside the cage, but my fight out. And that includes fighting against the stigma of medical cannabis. As a medical cannabis patient, I'm in the process of getting a therapeutic use exemption in cannabis for competition. It's been an uphill battle with USADA in the sense that they have in many ways an outdated mind, and it's throughout this process that I've really noticed that they probably don't want to do it in general because of the precedence that it'll make. But any fight worth doing is going to be difficult, and it's going to take a long time to get it all together, and I'm pushing forward. And one of the interesting things with USADA is they never say no, they just deny you and they ask for more information. And since this 18-month process that I've been in, they're finding less and less opportunity and less things to say no to. So, my next fight may be against Eric Anders, but my biggest fight is not against one man, but against the stigma of medical cannabis.
And I feel like things are so backwards. I remember back in the day, like Matthew Riddell, or Riddle, he got kicked out of the UFC. Even Nick Diaz getting in trouble for a couple of years. Just like really harsh punishments. Like we see less punishments for PEDs and stuff like that. And it doesn't make any sense. Like after fights, people, they go out. Even we saw Conor McGregor drunk at the press conference. That's doing a lot more damage than marijuana, at least in my honest opinion. It's something that definitely needs to change.
Yeah, no, definitely. And even kind of going back to the USADA aspect, it's kind of like a little bit of hypocrisy in the sense that one of the things that they told me is I need to do essentially more prescription drugs because they're first-line medicines, right? So and they're all. This is also at the time when USADA is having a campaign where they're trying to fight opioid addiction, but yet they're telling me to do more opioids. So it's a little, it doesn't make a lot of sense. Part of this is the fact that in the U.S., it is still a Schedule One drug, which means it has no medical property. But in Canada, it's fully legalized, and we've actually had medical cannabis for over a decade now. Even to the point where I would say that, don't just take my word for it, that cannabis should be removed from the prohibited list. There you go. Too much water and cutting weight at this point. My brain's a little... But it's currently on the prohibited list, which means it's at the same level of steroids and HGH in regards to what you can find. And not saying that he is, but someone like Eric Anders or any opponent for that matter could opt out for something like Vicodin, and if it was in their system, it wouldn't be an issue. But if it was the cannabis is in my system, I'll get suspended for like months, if not years. So it's kind of head scratching, but that's part of the stigma, and that's part of the reason why I'm trying to use my platform to break down these barriers.
Anyone out there that knows anything about opiates and what it can do to your body and how addictive it is, that should piss anybody off that that is the way things are. So things definitely need to change. I live in Connecticut. We have places around here that sell it medically. And I know in Canada, they just actually, legalized it? Or what did they do up
nationwide.
There? Nationwide,
it's
yeah.
It's really illegal, but even more so, and this is where it comes into, again, fundamental Canadian rights. It's attached to healthcare, and healthcare is considered a fundamental Canadian right. And USADA, unfortunately, doesn't. Again, this is not my word for it. It's my medical practitioner and my medical practitioner, Solos Health Network, and also my actual family physician that has diagnosed me in regards to using cannabis for pain, pain management, and more specifically, my bilateral neuropathic pain. And again, it's one of those things that USADA is kind of fighting me on this because they know that the precedent that they'll make, not just for myself, but all for all Canadian athletes.
Elias, I want to thank you so much. That's something I'm really interested in. I really, really hope that you're one of the leading guys to make a change for that because it's slowly but surely people are starting to understand the old ways are dying off, and I'm sure it'll be no time before we can make something happen here. So I appreciate you going out there, putting your name on the line in front of it and fighting for this. That means a lot to a lot of people out there.
Thanks, man. And I appreciate your time as always. And talk again soon. Hopefully sooner than rather than later.
Last but not least, if you have any shout outs, anything at all, the floor is now all yours, Elias.
No, obviously, you know, I hope everyone tunes into my fight and also the pay-per-view as well. I'm really excited to put on a show for my hometown and everyone watching.
Elias will be tuning in. Thank you so much, and we'll talk to you soon.
Talk soon, bud.
We got a really special guest.